This week on FMA, find out how the two young stars were able to be sexy while shooting their music video underwater. How deep is the water? Three-time Canadian figure skating champion, top finalist of So You Think You Can Dance Canada. Now let's see what Emanuel Sandhu is going to do next. We're sitting down with international supermodel CoCo Rocha and not discussing fashion, but love.
Why do you want to date me, especially when you know you're never going to see me sort of thing?
And then let's hit the streets with WTF. All these and much more this week on FMA.
Hi there, I'm Erin Ireland and welcome to FMA, your entertainment and lifestyle show for fashion, music and art. Singers and twin sisters Carmen and Camille, whose music has been featured on The Hills, returned to the West Coast after a UK tour, and our Narina De Jager got to chat with them after one of their shows.
Good evening, girls. Carmen, oh no, Camille and Carmen, I'm confused already. Now, you girls are just back from the tour in the UK, and I have to say, I see no sign of jet lag whatsoever. You look fabulous.
Oh, look a little closer.
Yes.
Smoke and mirrors, we're both feeling a little bit out of it, but excited to play tonight.
Is it good to be back home?
It is good to be back home. We actually just moved to LA, though, and so I'm kind of feeling right now, like, where do I live? I'm so confused, but we haven't quite learned how to pack light yet.
They're definitely not. No. So many shoes.
It's the shoes. I know, the shoes in the bag, always a problem. But you've been...
Boots like this, though, it's hard to fit, like, two pairs of these boots is taking up half of a suitcase. In typical Carmen and Camille fashion, we were late to get to the airport, but we still had time to go and buy some Warburton's crumpets.
And it must be certainly very awesome to be family and be involved in something like this with the support of your sisters.
I don't know how solo artists do it, because it's like you play these shows and then you're back in a hotel room or whatever after, and it's kind of like this kind of deflation of, okay, the show's over, and then you're kind of by yourself in some place where you don't know anyone, and it's like, I've got Camille.
Talking about Shine For You, I absolutely love that tune. I can see it played in clubs forever. Don't you find it so amazing that you will be part of people's memories for such a long time?
Well, I certainly hope that happens.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like that.
I'm going to be totally dancing to that for a very, very long time.
Oh, Narina thinks she can dance. Well, I met someone who certainly can. So, Emanuel, you think you can dance?
I think I'm not a bad dancer now.
Well, I don't either, from what I've seen, that's for sure. Well, thanks for having me here. It's such a comfy setting here.
Are you comfortable? I'm comfortable.
I'm very comfortable. I've never done this before. First time.
This is the first time, too. I'm glad we thought of this idea.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
So what first made you decide to switch to the dancing and veer off the path? Because, I mean, you are this amazing, you know, award-winning figure skater. Mm. So what made you switch?
Well, if people don't know my history, I'll give them a brief rundown. I started dancing when I was 3. I didn't start skating until I was about 7 or 8, okay. And I auditioned for the National Ballet School at that time, and I got in. I did both in tandem for about 10 years, but I kept the skating completely secret from the people at the National because they didn't want people doing sort of extracurricular activities.
Okay.
And then somebody found out, and I tried to do both in tandem again, but there came a point when I was supposed to, you know, sort of choose whether or not I wanted to join the company as a professional dancer, if I wanted to choose skating, and what I did was I chose skating. It was a good choice, and you know, it's almost like I've come full circle. And
totally. Well, tell us some of your big titles. I mean,
as a skater?
Olympian,
yeah.
Yeah, Canadian men's champion.
Three-time Canadian men's figure skating champion. I am 2-time Olympian. What else? I've got a lot of like international medals and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. But I've worked really hard for it, so. And, you know, for me, people might ask, well, what's a figure skater doing on So You Think You Can Dance Canada? I mean, and my reply to that is, well, they're both highly skilled professions. They both take a lot of training. The most for me is just the performance art aspect of them.
A winding staircase leads upwards from Robson Street to the celebrated Vancouver dining room, Chin Chin. The elegant restaurant is recognized for its Italian menu and an award-winning wine cellar. Bright Light Pictures hosted the annual gala event, inviting some of Vancouver's most popular A-list talents. And FMA was proud to be part of this exclusive party. Three-time Canadian figure skating champion, top finalist of So You Think You Can Dance Canada. Now let's see what Emanuel Sandhu is going to do next. We're sitting down with international supermodel CoCo Rocha and not discussing fashion, but love.
Why do you want to date me, especially when you know you're never going to see me sort of thing?
Mm-hmm. Next on FMA. Closed captioning brought to you by Vancouver View Magazine. Vancouver's number one magazine keeps the readers on top of what's new and worthy of their attention with award-winning editorial. The Olympic Special Edition is on the newsstands now. Visit www.vancouverview.net. The bed as my interview with Emanuel Sandhu gets a little more personal as he tells me some set secrets.
Are there any behind the scenes set secrets you can share with us, or maybe even embarrassing stories, funny stories? It's not.
I wish it was more exciting, but you know, the dancing spoke for itself. That was the exciting part. I split my pants a few times on set, but that was on TV, so people.
It was on TV?
People saw that, yeah.
Was that highlighted or is that?
Oh, yeah, it was on fashion TV.
Oh. Was it that the pants were like kind of just loose or they were really tight or what?
I just split the ass right out of them because I danced really hard. So,
so singing?
Yeah.
So that's kind of like a new venture for you? Like maybe some Friday night karaoke thing?
Well, I'd like to go beyond that, but the karaoke started just simply because my friend, friend of mine, Jill Marie, used to go once in a while to a good place to just hang out and have a beer and chill. And the first time I went, it was horrible. I was so bad. I sang Chain of Fools. And
I'm sure it's the first time.
Well, I hadn't sang Chain of Fools since I was like before puberty, so I'm like, this is really high. And okay, I gotta stop. And after that, I just got more and more into it. And it sounds funny, but I actually go sometimes to practice because, you know, it's just a way to actually get out in front of a crowd. But I've gone beyond that, and, you know, I've written my first single called Burn Up the Floor. And
yeah,
yeah, and
exciting.
Yeah, I've got some other ideas stuck in my head, but I think what I'd really like to do, it's not just in music. I mean, I see myself putting together a show that would be really theatrical.
Let's get started. Your eyes are telling me that you want it. No time to waste, let's get on it.
And judging by his past success, his music will no doubt be a hit. Now, speaking of success, we get an inside look at dating through the eyes of a supermodel. I sat down with CoCo Rocha.
So being the attractive and hugely successful woman that you are, do you find it hard to meet a man? I mean, do they get intimidated?
I don't know so much about intimidation, but I feel a little nervous actually being around guys, because you wonder why they want to be around you. Is it for the right reasons? I mean, starting off not having a boyfriend, all of a sudden, not that bullies fall all over me, but the fact that you just wonder, why does this person want to be around you? Is it because of the modeling? Is it because of the, you know, what you think comes with a girlfriend that is a model? So it's a little confusing for me more than for them, I think.
So has that happened before? Have you noticed somebody trying to glom onto you?
I've noticed a few, especially when I come home to Vancouver, and I'm like, why do you want to date me? Especially when you know you're never going to see me, sort of thing. Mm-hmm. But I've just recently found a great guy. We've been best friends for 2 years, and I think that's the greatest thing. You usually do, I guess, fall in love with your best friend, if anybody. But
so what is the biggest misconception with dating a model and someone in your line of work?
That it's so glamorous. I think a lot of guys think, you know, she'll be around, we'll go to parties, we'll hang out. I like my pajamas and I like to watch TV, and I don't like to leave when I'm not working. So I wonder if he thought he was going to get that package.
And so how do you find the Vancouver man compared to the international man or the other nationalities that you perhaps met?
It's funny. I find the boys here a little more abrupt. I'm not going to lie.
You know, I think I know what you mean, actually.
But again, I also don't mind that so much because there's a lot of guys out there that won't speak their mind, whereas here they will definitely speak their mind. And I do also know a few guy friends here that are very respectable. Believe it or not, there are a few of them out here. When I was younger, FYI, everyone, this is my first boyfriend. But when I was younger, I definitely thought that he had to be rich. You know, the whole thing. He had to be Prince Charming. He had to be rich. He had to be good looking. He had to be 6 foot something. I don't know. This was my dream.
No, we all had it.
James is definitely not rich. He's not the best looking guy. But he's gonna hate me. He's gonna hate me right now.
Well, so if he doesn't see this.
But he will. He would agree with me. But he would. He's definitely the most nicest, respectful gentleman. I mean, he puts everybody into consideration. And because of those things, it makes him all the other things. So I'm really happy to be around him.
Before the commercial break, here's a 30-second glimpse into the exciting events happening around your city. The annual January 1st Polar Bear Swim is one of the world's oldest and largest events. To help kick the new year off with a chill, polar bear style. After the break, let's check back with Carmen and Camille and their hot underwater music video.
How deep is the water?
And then let's hit the streets with WTF. Next on FMA. This is brought to you by Chic Walks, an iPhone shopping app for visiting fashionistas. GPS-enabled, so you can browse the stylish catalog and immediately take advantage of exclusive merchant offers. Download Cheekwalks on iTunes App Stores now.
Today's WTF is truly WTF. In my hand, I have a list of real questions posed by foreigners about Vancouver, and we're going to try to get them some answers. Someone from Sweden has asked, I want to walk from Vancouver to Toronto. Can I follow the railroad track?
Absolutely.
You could help build some more track if you want. There's a lot of uncharted land in Canada.
And they shouldn't be wearing their headphones in case a train comes.
Yes, as long as you're wearing comfortable shoes, I wouldn't recommend spike heels, but platforms, no problem.
Yes, like while doing the gross grind. I mean, you can wear jeans, you can bring a boombox.
I think that heels are mandatory for the gross grind, so pack those.
Pack your lunch.
It could be a fun trip.
It could be fun.
This is from England. Are there any ATMs in Canada? And if so, can you give me a list of them in Toronto, Vancouver, Edmonton, and Halifax?
You'll find one. Just look on each corner. Yeah.
They only distribute change. We only have a coin monetary system here. And you usually have to sing a song to get it out. We don't have any cards.
We are just starting to introduce money, but we're really more with the barter system, so you don't need an ATM. Just, like, bring lots to trade.
Like spices.
Yeah, spices, beads.
Fabric.
Fabric works well.
Meats, like cured meats.
Yeah, Starbucks gift cards.
Starbucks? We just got our first Starbucks.
Oh, that's pretty exciting. I'll have to check it out.
Are there supermarkets in Canada, and is milk available year-round?
Yes, we milk our bison, but we don't have any other produce. It's mostly bison and whale blubber. We harvest it from coast to coast.
And you can milk anything with nipples.
If you ask nicely.
That's correct. Yes, there are supermarkets available, and milk is available at your local convenience store.
Well, that's a tough one. We Canadians, we tend to, when we get hungry, we go in the backyard and dig up some pemmican.
But we usually only drink milk in the winter.
Directly from the cow, actually, in the summer.
Really? Well, I thought that was only my family, but yours too?
We may be related.
So we probably are.
I kind of wish I was.
Well, we have lots of cows, but when it's cold, it's more like frozen ice cream. Yeah. So milk or ice cream, take your pick.
Can you send me the Vienna Boys Choir schedule?
I don't know anything about that. Well, let's ask someone.
Yeah, well, we're open. Anybody?
That's Austria. Not Canada.
Well, I have that written on the back of my hand. Oh no, it got washed off. What am I going to do? But I'll get that to you soon.
Someone from the USA writes, I have a question about a famous animal in Canada, but I forget its name. It's a kind of big horse with horns. Now, can we guess what that would be for them?
Like Santa Claus's animal? The reindeer.
Oh, that's what they were asking about.
I won't even go with who I was going to say because it's too political.
A moose. Yeah, we've got moose here. Is it, or elk? Yeah, we have both of those.
It's a unicorn. It has one horn.
It's called the Celine Dion.
I honestly don't remember the last time I laughed so hard. Those guys must have been comedians. Now, back to an arena and more with Carmen and Camille.
Please join Carmen and Camille.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love, in all our sons come back.
So let's get personal for a little bit.
Who's older?
I am older by 2 minutes.
Does she ever pull rank on you?
Do you? She'll tease me.
I do feel like the older sister, though.
Yeah, she's slightly more responsible, I'm not going to lie. A little better with finances and responsibility and driving and normal day-to-day things.
She's so busy. Do you get time for relationships?
It's gotten harder and harder to sustain a relationship. My significant other lives in a whole different country, so that's already hard enough. But I get lots of free time.
I've noticed that you have literally been all over the world, and you filmed one of your music videos in Turkey, I do believe.
Yeah, we shot it in Budapest, actually. It was partially in photographs and partially in video. It's kind of a new thing to do, and it was fun.
I also noticed that it was very cold on the day that you did shoot the video. Whom of you did the falling into the water in such freezing weather?
Me, and that was at like 3 in the morning after a long day of filming. And we get like all the makeup and hair, and we've already been shooting stuff. Camille's having to do scenes like holding hands with a guy. Then my scenes are falling backwards into the water and then walking into a lake. And don't forget the one where you had to stick your head underwater, open your eyes, and sing to a camera.
And sing under the water, literally bubbles coming out of your mouth.
You're not breathing enough bubbles out. Sing and open your eyes wider underwater. I'm like,
how deep is the water?
I must say, I love your style, and I've noticed that you are a massive fan of Jacqueline Connor, as am I. Why do you like her so much?
She's just really a great designer. Like, you're so pretty. Like, it's very feminine stuff, but there is also elements of, like, she's really good at doing suits.
Yeah, there's good stuff for all occasions. She was nice enough to lend us some of her dresses for some events in LA and stuff, and yeah, I just love her stuff.
I do believe you are cooking up quite a storm in LA with a new TV series as well, right?
Yep, we shot that a little while ago, and when we get back to LA, we're really hoping to be having some meetings and getting things organized with that. We're really hoping it takes off.
Do you dream big? You want to be at the Grammys one day, and I have to say, you are fabulous. Your music is really good, and you're already living in LA, so you're halfway there.
Yeah, we do want a Grammy one day, though.
Yeah, we've definitely been to the Grammys a few times, but now it's time to get one.
Yeah.
Camille, and you're watching FMA.
Next on FMA, we have our fashion expert Jolie Chan giving us the 101 in Minutes à la Mode.
Let's face it, ladies, there are never enough bags in our wardrobe. I have chosen the hottest picks from the celebrities this season, the bags that would fit perfectly in your wardrobe that you could use every day. Try a pink Diana de Maria bag that Sarah Jessica Parker has been using. It's a nice decent size to put all your goodies in. Or try an ultra glam black Givenchy bag that Hilary Duff has been caught using. It's a really nice big size bag that you can put over your shoulder and just go everywhere with. You can put all your good stuff in. Tons of room for everything. You can also try a red hot Jimmy Choo purse that Rachel Bilson has been using. It's a great bag to use every day to go shopping in. Or, for a more extreme look, try a rock star black studded Yves Saint Laurent bag that Lady Gaga has been using. Ladies, I hope you find your perfect bag or bags for the season. I'm Jolie Chan. I'll see you next week.
That's it for today on FMA. You can check our website, fmaweekly.com, for archived shows and much more. See you next week.
Next week on FMA. Guess which local DJ played for many Hollywood stars, including Jennifer Aniston. We'll be meeting with Chan Han Go, former prima ballerina of the National Ballet of Canada. Also, we've got a one-on-one with a man who's been in 24, Fringe, and many Hollywood movies. Then we'll be hitting one of Whistler's most prestigious restaurants, Araxi.
Is there any chance of you eating a little mini hamburger on camera? That's what the people want to see.
That seems big, but okay.
And then let's hit the streets with WTF.
What are the languages of Canada?
German and Spanish.
and much more next week on FMA.